Hello, friends. Welcome to Shelter in Place. Scripture, inspiration, prayer. Take a sip of life. Lord, you are always there waiting for me. May I never be too busy to find time to spend in your presence. 1 John 1, 1-4, NLT. We proclaim to you the one who existed from the beginning, whom we have heard and seen. We saw him with our own eyes and touched him with our own hands. He is the word of life. This one who is life itself was revealed to us, and we have seen him. And now we testify and proclaim to you that he is the one who is eternal life. He was with the Father, and then he was revealed to us. We proclaim to you what we ourselves have actually seen and heard, so that you may have fellowship with us. And our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that you may fully share our joy. Today's quotation comes to us from Pope John Paul II, born Karol Józef Wojtyła, and who was Pope, head of the Catholic Church from 1978 to 2005. It is Jesus that you seek when you dream of happiness. He is waiting for you when nothing else you find satisfies you. He is the beauty to which you are so attracted. It is he who provoked you with that thirst for fullness that will not let you settle for compromise. It is he who urges you to shed the masks of a false life. It is he who reads in your heart your most genuine choices, the choices that others try to stifle. It is Jesus who stirs in you the desire to do something great with your lives, the will to follow an ideal, the refusal to allow yourselves to be ground down by mediocrity, the courage to commit yourselves humbly and patiently to improving yourselves and society, making the world more human and more fraternal. The Apostle John tells us in today's scripture that Jesus is the one who is life itself. John Paul II tells us that it is Jesus whom we seek when we dream of happiness. He is the source of life, abundant, satisfying, full life. We can fully share the joy of the early disciples and heroes of the faith down through the centuries because Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is eternal life and the one who welcomes each of us to share that life with him right now. Give yourself fully to him and follow him wherever he leads you. He makes all things new and beautiful and holy and good. Nothing else will completely satisfy you. Shed the masks of a false life and embrace him and the full life he is waiting to live in and through and with you. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Thank you for joining me. See you next time.